Centers, Assalamu alaikum. Today my topic is The Many and the None, an important passage written by Bansuri, Teneja and Asish Kothari. Through this passage, these authors have highlighted the importance of conservation of biodiversity. Students, it is my fourth lecture related to this important topic. It is page number 77 of your textbook, Chanar First. Please open your textbook and listen silently. How these two authors highlight the importance of conservation of biodiversity. Though it concerns all of us, biodiversity is most directly related to the everyday lives of India's ecosystem people. Hundreds of millions of small farmers, fisher folk, herders, and hunter-gatherers, a substantial number of them tribal, depend on the diversity of species, genetic varieties, and ecosystem services for their livelihoods and cultural lives. It provides them with their fuel, food, fodder for livestock, housing material, medicine, and spiritual sustenance. The fiber of biodiversity is a direct attack on their very survival. For this part of humanity, the ship is already sinking. According to authors, biodiversity concerns all of us. But it is very directly related to the everyday lives of India's ecosystem people, as hundreds of small farmers, fisher folk, herders, and hunter-gatherers depend on the diversity of species, genetic varieties, and ecosystem services for their livelihoods and cultural lives. Any loss of it is a direct attack on their survival. It is important to note here that the presence of just any species functioning as a resource is not adequate. It is the diversity of species, of animals and plants, and even microorganisms that is valuable to rural communities. As Jagat Singh Chaudhary of the Kamau Himalaya, one of the many thousands of ecosystem people, explains, there should be every kind of tree in the forest. There should be fodder trees, fuel wood trees, and those which keep the soil moist. Diversity of species of animals and plants and microorganisms is valuable to rural communities. As Jagat Singh Chaudhary of the Kumau Himalayas has rightly laid due stress on the diversity of species as of the greatest importance to the ecosystem people in the country. He said that there should be every kind of tree in the forest. There should be fodder trees, fuel trees, and those which keep the soil moist. To him, each and every kind of tree should be preserved in a forest. Like bunch, kafai, ayar, buranas, they will keep our soil humid and their leaves will make humus that will have organic diversity. There should be fruit trees also, and the trees which will supply wood for building purposes. To him, each and every kind of tree should be in a forest. There should be fodder trees. There should be trees meant for timber. There should be trees with broad leaves. There should be trees which retain water. And there should be trees which keep the moisture of soil. There should be fruit trees also, and trees which will supply wood for building purposes. And the most important trees are those which will keep the environment clean, broad-leafed ones. He lays stress that broad-leafed trees should be in the forests because they keep the environment clean by taking in a lot of carbon dioxide and giving a great amount of oxygen. The rest are for industry. Rambanas, banas, ringal, and the grass and the creepers. Other than these, creepers are the main source for fodder. What elders say is that earlier there were dense forests and there were many species in them, but now in the monoculture pine forests there is no diversity. To him, in olden days, there were dense forests which were full of diverse kinds of trees. There were different types of trees, but in nowadays there is no diversity from trees. If trees, grass, herbs, creepers, etc. all grow, then won't be there an economic development. If trees, grass, herbs, creepers, etc. all grow, then won't there be economic development. He says, we believe that if we grow different diverse types of trees in forest, it will hinder our economic development. That is not true. To this great scholar, Jagat Singh Chaudhary of Kamau, Himalayas, diversity of trees should be maintained in forests, as it will rather add our economic development instead of hindering our economic development. Thanks. Stay blessed.